citizens who wrote that actually just this morning. At the last council meeting, the six resolutions submitted by Councilmembers Crow and Carr were removed from the agenda at the beginning of the meeting before any discussion of the resolutions could take place. I've learned that they're on the agenda again. I urge you to leave the items on the agenda this time so that a full and fair discussion of the resolutions can be had. First of all, the citizens of University City deserve to know where each of you stand on each of these resolutions and why you are either for or against them. In particular, the citizens deserve to understand your positions regarding the city manager's decision to suspend six firefighters, the decision which potentially endangers the citizens of University City. Additionally, with respect to the resolution regarding Councilmember Crow, why was it acceptable to reprimand Councilmember Price, but to not reprimand Councilmember Crow for what is apparently similar conduct? Secondly, as we pointed out more than once at the last meeting, removing items from the agenda put forth by other members of the council prevents the voices of the minority from being heard. Our democratic process is in place to protect the rights of the minority and the ability for the voices of the minority to be heard. Removing items from the agenda, as was done at the last meeting, defeats the very purpose of our democratic process. Finally, Mayor Wells, Councilmembers Craig, Blicker, Sharp, and Jennings, although we are in the majority now, someday one of you may find yourself in the minority. When that occurs and you put forth a resolution, you will undoubtedly want that resolution discussed in the same way that Councilmembers Crow and Carr want their resolutions discussed, asking each of you to give the other members of the council the respect each expects in return is not asking too much. Stated differently, you should treat each other as you wish to be treated by others. Finally, one that just came in was, I think, very interesting, and went to the entire body, except actually Mr. James, that this citizen asked to report it on you because she did not have hers. This one is addressed to the mayor and all members of the council. I see that the resolutions that were so shockingly dismissed with 2 weeks ago are again on tonight's agenda. What I witnessed 2 weeks ago was disgraceful. The blatant disrespect by the way showed the 2,000 members who initiated these resolutions went beyond disgracing the officers you hold. We, as you and your constituents, were also shown the ultimate disrespect. Our city deserves better. We are a university city. Our diversity, not divisiveness, makes us strong, effective, and envied by other communities. Our progressive vibrancy, not divisiveness, is what puts us in the headlines. You, as our leaders, have a duty to nurture community solidarity, not destroy it. Do not think for a moment that because the council chamber is not filled to capacity, the citizens of this community are not upset at what has transpired these past 2 months. Dismay, disgust, and sadness are what keeps many of us away. This needs to end, and you are the ones to do so. I look forward to a full and honest discussion of all the resolutions on tonight's agenda. Additionally, I believe you put our city manager on notice that his excessive and retaliatory actions will no longer be tolerated, and that his behavior during the last election will be examined and may be subject to disciplinary action. Finally, please find ways to get our government back to work and to let people begin. So I will ask one more time, why is it that the majority of this council does not want to take a vote on these resolutions? And again, to all of you who came out again tonight, thank you for coming. I apologize. It looks clearly like we're not going to get to see a vote once again, but we'll put them on next meeting.